Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. Happy New Year to everybody. But as we close out 2020, it's important for me to take a look back and see what exactly happened in the handgun world. And that's what this video is about. We're going to talk about many of the best of for handguns for 2020. So let's get to it. Let's start by talking about the best expansion from a single handgun, and that belongs to Sig Sauer. What they've done with the P320 is incredible. It started out with just a new modular type of handgun, but that expanded to the X Carry, then the X Compact. Now we're looking at the metal frame AXG Scorpion, the RXP Compact, the X5 Legion, the P320 M17. It just goes on and on and on. And they have so many optic ready P320s out there. They call it the Red Dot Revolution. They've taken that single gun and expanded far greater than anybody thought they would. And each time they come out with a new model, people's heads are spinning and they are lining up to get them. The best handgun tees that started out in 2019 that is near impossible to find even in 2020 is the CZ P10S. Now I realize when I don't say everything glowing about CZ on this channel, it's like blasphemy. But there was so much excitement over the P10S and nobody could find it. And we thought that, you know, maybe importation issues, they have a plant in Kansas City, it would change all that. And I still get comments today, people saying, I want the P10S, the optic ready model, and I just can't find it. I'm starting to see them now, but I consider that one of the greatest teases in handgun history, coming right from one of my favorite manufacturers, CZ USA. What I consider the most innovative handgun of 2020 is the Kel-Tec CP33. They took a handgun and created a 33-round magazine standard in 22 long rifle. There are also rumors that they're coming out with a 5.7 by 28mm model called the P50 that offers 50 rounds. Now, if that is true, there were leaked photos which suggest that it is true, that they are extremely innovative. Now, what Kel-Tec is also a master of is artificial scarcity. They get everybody all excited over certain models and they are near impossible to find. And when you do find them, the price is so high that it becomes unaffordable. But I still think what they did with that CP33 is pretty amazing. I'm fortunate to get my hands on one and review it, but it would be nice if it became more available for everybody else. The most customer-friendly upgrade that I saw in 2020 without raising the price has to go to the Taurus G3C. They took the G2C, made it better by improving the trigger, adding front serrations, interchangeable sights, and a third magazine with an MSRP remaining at $305. And the G2C was so popular, people consider that the best gun for the money. Now, the G3C with a third magazine, I remind you, has the same budget price with the same size, weight, and specifications for the most part, that people really enjoyed it. And Taurus made it available to their customers and people were eating them up as fast as they could. The best pistol to raise 5.7 by 28 millimeter from the dead, in which FN had a stranglehold upon that round. They were the only ones at the time, almost, to make firearms chambered in 5.7 by 28 millimeter is the Ruger 5.7. They did an amazing job. They came out with the 5.7 20 round magazines. They created a great full-size handgun that a lot of people wanted. It took the world by surprise, and they brought that round back from the dead, and now what you're seeing is so many other companies are jumping on board. Ruger leads the way in so many areas, and they most definitely did in 2020 with that Ruger 5.7, and what they did with that model brought that round back from the dead, and many people, including yours truly, is really enjoying the variety. The manufacturer that has made a comeback better than any that I've seen, from where they were to where they are now to where they are going, is hands down Diamondback. Look what they did to the DB9. They now have a Gen 4 that remains one of the smallest and lightest pocket guns in the entire industry, but yet it's extremely reliable with a better trigger and many other upgrades that people wanted with that line. The AM2. It is an amazing handgun that people were picking up for a little over $200. Look at the DBX57. They took that growing round and created a subgun that is an incredible shooter, and people love it. I love it, and I was so happy they did that. And then you look at their rifle line. Okay, what you're looking at here is my DB15 in Midnight Bronze. They have their own upgrades to it, including the muzzle, the upper. Many of the parts that they use are not normal parts that you would get when you purchase an AR-15. So Diamondback, you are the comeback kid of 2020, and I don't see you slowing down at all. The manufacturer that has created some of the most beautiful customizations of their existing models is Magnum Research. Look what they've done with the Desert Eagle line. They now have a website in which you can build your own Desert Eagle. Everything from the colors to the upgrades to the barrel length, like you name it, you can build your own custom Desert Eagle. And that's what I did. And what you're looking at is my custom Desert Eagle with gold and black with some upgrades to it. It's incredible the way they have made customization the norm amongst Desert Eagle handguns in 2020. You can also look at their 1911 line with all of the Cerakotes and custom engraving. You're looking at We the People Desert Eagle, but it goes much further than that. And I think it's amazing. If you're a collector, you love the beautiful one-of-a-kind look, and Magnum Research provided that for us in 2020. The best underrated pistol in 2020, in my opinion, is the Rex Delta. It's a great handgun. It's priced under $400, and it offers everything that the Glocks, the Smiths, the Walthers offer, but with less money, and it's actually a little bit lighter, and it's an excellent shooting handgun. Now, when the Rex 01 came out, the gun world was taken by storm. They loved it. They said, this thing looks like a SIG, but in many ways, it's better. They did the exact same thing with the Delta, and nobody's talking about it, and nobody wants it, and I don't understand. I have it. I've raved about it all year long. I'm shocked. It's a great gun, and it disassembles real easy. It just, the slide just pops off. It's accurate. It's reliable. It has interchangeable sights. It has a little heavier trigger, but it sure does function fine. It's passed many different reliability tests. And why aren't people liking or loving the Rex Delta? I don't know, but I'm hoping that 2021 changes things. The best gun to push the industry boundaries when we talk about magazine capacity for subcompact handguns is none other than Springfield Armory with the Hellcat. 11 rounds with a flat base plate and a little subcompact magazine, that's amazing. Then they have the 13 round mag. Now, I know people are going to say, well, SIG did it first, and then SIG now has a 12 round mag, and Shield S15 now makes it for the Glock. That's true, but it was Springfield Armory who pushed the boundaries, and they created the situation where other people had to catch up. And we see that all the time in the gun world, but Springfield started it. Now, in terms of the Shield S15, they did a great job, but Glock didn't do that. Glock is the master of aftermarket parts and accessories. They are. Everybody wants to customize their Glocks, but Springfield Armory started it with the Hellcat. It's a great carry gun, and that magazine capacity did, it really did, push the industry boundaries. Prior to 2020, Rock Island Armory had 2+P rated 38 special revolvers. They were fine, you know, snub nose and another with a little bit of a longer barrel. But what they have managed to do when they started to import from the Czech Republic, from Alpha Prage, those revolvers into the US, the AL line that included 357 Magnum, 38 Special, now 22 Magnum, 22 Long Rifle, 9mm, has been amazing. They're high-end revolvers. They make them in stainless and blued, equivalent to some of the other makers out there, but for a little less money. And we're used to that with Rock Island Armory, but their revolver line now has expanded with extreme quality. And I don't know if it has caught on, but they sure are nice revolvers, and I think people should take another look at these, because I certainly have been impressed. So that was my best 10 handgun situations for 2020. I'm interested to hear what you think. Let me know what I missed. I will also mention the best followers of any channel on YouTube for 2020 and prior is right here. And you are appreciated. If you like videos like this, please subscribe and share. I always appreciate the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and you guys be safe.